Hey everyone, and welcome back to another episode of this Father and Son Let's Play. Tonight I'm by myself. Kids already gone to bed, so I was gonna get some grinding and maybe a little bit else out of the way. I do have something to show you guys, though. Ta-da! I built that house. I changed what materials I was going to use, but it kept the same footprint. Instead of making it out of quartz on the outside, I made it out of white concrete and just used the quartz as floor inside. There's not really much in here, including no lighting. Let's fix that real quick. But yeah, it's a standard modern house. Used white concrete, acacia wood, cyan terracotta, and quartz for the floor. Made it a little dock that comes out this way, and got light gray stained glass for the windows, although I might switch that out for just regular gray. And I just put a hole here so I can get out easier when I'm up top. I have plans. I'm going to do up the interior a little bit. What else? I'm really bad at interior design, so if you guys have any tips or suggestions, I'm all ears. Leave it in the comments. I'm thinking maybe a little kitchen corner here, TV and couch here, maybe a dining room table or kitchen table right there. I don't know. Maybe some plants outside. I'm not really good at the decorating part. I do plan on terraforming this whole island and getting rid of the mycelium. So maybe I will get some inspiration from the greenery when that happens. Yeah, I finally made that house this week. Or last week. But in this episode, I want to get started on some villager shenanigans. I want to set up a breeder and an iron farm. And if I get around to it this week, I want to set up a mob farm as well, just to get some gunpowder and bones and arrows and stuff flowing in. Not real sure where I want to set the things up. It's going to be temporary because eventually I will move everything underground, because these types of farms are pretty ugly. Like, just huge eyesores, honestly. And I hate looking at them. So I may put the iron farm over there. I may put the villager breeder down that way. And there you can see my kid's kelp farm. Not super efficient or anything, but it works. I think he's been up to quite a few stuff. Quite a few things. When I wasn't on this past weekend. We can take a look at it next time me and him play. But for now, I just want to start gathering some materials and making preparations for the breeder and the iron farm. And I don't want this video to be as long as the last one, so let me go gather some materials and yeah, I'll be back when we're ready to start building. And I'm back. So I went ahead and got all the resources. And actually just, went ahead and built the breeder I'm going to make. It is impulseSV's design. I use a lot of his designs, and I like how simple a lot of his stuff is. But yeah, it's just a carrot farm. You'll put a farmer in there and get two more villagers and put them inside those trapdoors. So, let's get us some villagers. I typically bring villagers back to my bases through the Nether, since it's, you know, 1/8 of the distance. But I'm not quite ready to build like a hub in the Nether. So what I also like to do there is move my portal up to, you know, one of the higher Y levels. 100, 110, around there, and clear out spaces and dig tunnels up there. And my pickaxe is, you know, down to almost half durability, and it just seems like a bad idea right now. And also, while I was out adventuring, I found this, which only is a minute away from the base, so we're gonna try and get some villagers down here and bring them over to the base. Let's see, what do we have? I would prefer them to not have a profession. Oh, that's a nice blue bed. I might steal that. I got a golem. Hey, guys. Either of y'all have professions. What are you? You must want to come with me. Let's go. What are you? Oh, my God. All right, we can't take both of y'all at the same time. Let's bring up those hitboxes so I don't get an iron golem on me. I would only like one of you, please. Is going about as good as the cows. Get in there. Yes. All right. Land boat. So I have a minecart track set up already to get this guy up to the farm area of the breeder. Hopefully that goes easy. F3 screen. Also, I've noticed squids are not spawning much in this world. Don't know if it's a server setting I need to tweak for passive mobs or water mobs. Doesn't seem like there's a whole lot of mushroom cows spawning on the island either. So, I don't know. Might be something I need to look into. I might need to clear out some stuff in the spawn chunks. I really don't know. I'm not great at the server admin thing. And here we are. So let's pull into where I have this station. Well, hope I actually made it big enough, I guess. Alright, get out of here. Oh, don't do that. Alright, let's see if I can get him in the minecart. Where the hell did he go? Sorry about the language. I don't know what's going on. Did he die? That was super weird. Alright, so let's not do that again. I guess what I'm gonna do. Build a little bit bigger place. platform here. Please, if anybody knows what happened to that villager, like, let me know down in the comments. Did I send him to space? I have never seen anything like that. Alright. Like, I still have hitboxes on. I don't even see him, like, out in the distance. That was super, super weird. Alright. Anyways, let's go back to this village real quick and grab us some more villagers. Alright. Well, got another one, so we are headed back to the base, and hopefully this guy doesn't get shot into orbit. Because this is going to get really tedious if that happens. I'm just glad that that village is right over there. Hopefully this should go better. I've got a little bit bigger platform for him. And I can push him into where that minecart is and send him up to the farm. Whoa, whoa, hey! Hey, guy! There's the other one. Oh, what? Boat, no. Boat, please. That is the least fun bug of this game. Alright. Put the hitbox is back on. Pop the boat. Get you up on the land. Go on. Go on. Nope. Alright. What? You. Oh, no. Oh, what are you doing? I hate villagers so much. So, so much. I'm tired of messing with him. See if I can get you in the minecart. Nope. Oh my god. Where are you going? Villager, please. Alright. Well, you're gonna get killed by a drowned, so I hope you're happy. So, this is Messing with Villagers, starring DeeK, who is absolutely horrible at this. Alright. Number two, going in. What the hell? This villager has an anti-gravity belt or something. Oh, he went straight into the bed. Okay. I was about to say. Now, when he wakes up, will he pathfind to these blocks? That is the question. We're not pathfind, but like automatically spawn on those. Oh, that's my boat. Let's go sleep real quick and check up on those guys. If they're good, we will go get one more and kick this thing off. And we're back with villager number three as soon as I take care of this glitch again. Minecraft be buggy. Never change, though. Once more for the hitboxes, and let's get this guy in his new permanent residence. Wait a second, where'd my minecart go? Oh my god. You are the biggest pain in my butt. There he goes. Yay. Oh, yay. Nope, nope. You stay. Get in there with your friend. Come on. Come on. Please? There you go. Y'all are gonna be best friends forever. So that took a little bit longer than I was expecting, but it is getting late, and it's a work night, so I'm gonna let this thing do its thing overnight and see where we're at in the morning. I didn't even go AFK yet. It's literally been like 45 seconds. I already got a baby. So I think this is going to work out pretty well for us. With that being said, I am for real going AFK now. It's nighttime, and both in real life and in the game. I'm going to sleep and then let this thing run overnight. And I will check back in with you all later. Alright, I am back. I've actually played a little bit more over the past day or so. I just hadn't had a chance to record. Brought up some villagers, and if you can tell by my inventory, I may have already built the iron farm. Can you see it? Can you see it over there? I just needed iron. But it is Doc M77's design. He designed it when he got word that 114.4 was actually going to be hopefully the last of the changes to Iron Golem spawning. And what I did was make your standard 3x3 killing chamber with a lava blade. All the drops get pushed over here, go into these chests. I've a 3-wide, 8-long water stream there to push them off, and then a 7-wide, 8-long water stream on each side to push them into the bottom one. And while I was making it, a cat spawned, so there's that. But it's a super simple design. It produces quite a bit of iron. It's got a 5x5 platform up top for them to spawn. A zombie underneath that sitting in a cauldron, and then on each side there's 3 villagers, each with a workstation and a bed. And that's not supposed to happen. What are you doing up there? Right, so I may have to put a carpet on that. I am gonna go, or a slab maybe? Yeah, I'm gonna go grab some slabs and remedy that real quick, because he is preventing more spawns. You want to drop the iron golems 20 to 25 blocks from where they spawn at, or where the villagers are, just so more have a chance to spawn. I think like every 10 seconds maybe the villagers, it checks to see if there's iron golem, and if not, there's X amount of chance for one to spawn. I'm not super technical. I just know it works. Let me scaffold on up there and gently guide this iron golem to the afterlife. By the way, scaffolding is a great new block. I mean, you can just sit here and hold right click and just build a tower. It's pretty amazing. You can get another aerial view of my water streams here. Like I said, it's super simple, standard type of killing mechanic. Oh, so close. This part does get a little tricky to build it higher when you're on top. You have to, the only way to make it go up is to do it from the side. And then you can do it from the top to make it go in a direction. And we gotta do it from the side again. Hey guy, how are you? Let's go that way. Oh, he landed on the mushroom. That's fine. Put a slab there. I wonder how hard it would be to scaffold over. The only bad thing about scaffolding is it only lets you go 6 out from the base without making another pillar. I think it's 6. Let's find out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, and then it falls. So, let's see. Probably pillar the rest or scaffold the rest of the way with this. That guy stole my sword and my hat. So, oh, that one just dropped. That was pretty neat. Yeah, so I died. I've died a few times here, actually. I got pushed into lava and lost my fancy pickaxe and shovel when I was trying to get lava for the killing mechanism down below. There, yeah. Got pushed into lava because I was in a rush and just not really paying attention. When I was all the way done with this, after I got this, oh, there goes another one. This is ridiculously efficient. Yeah, I got the zombie finally in there, started breaking down all the scaffolding. I had built a minecart track up here. I was probably about right here next, like, out from the zombie. An iron golem spawned right where I was breaking blocks, and I hit him, and he launched me up in the air and killed me instantly. All my stuff scattered, and he managed to grab my sword and my hat. But that's fine. That means he won't despawn, because he has my stuff, and I don't have a name tag. So I guess it worked out in the end. I am super bummed that I lost my good pick and good shovel, because along with dying, or what comes along with dying, is 0 levels, and can't enchant anything with 0 levels. So, there's another one. Man, this thing is super efficient. So what I think I'm going to do is first push you, finish pillaring down. Wait, just keep lighting him on fire till he dies, because I don't really want him walking around down here. So, yeah, I think what I'm going to do is get some villagers and just try to reset some trades real quick and get some cheap, like, unbreaking fortune efficiency traders from over there. Okay, sorry. Please. There we go. He's gonna take forever to kill. I'm gonna let him walk around for now. Yeah, we're gonna go back to the village breeder and see how that's doing. You know, in 114 now, you can get pretty cheap enchanted books from villagers, and you can force RNG them to give you the books you want. You just keep resetting their workstations, and they'll keep changing professions, and if you don't trade with them, yeah, it'll just keep resetting and resetting until you get what you want. Then you can also have them turn into a zombie villager and then cure them, and the price, you get just a ridiculous discount. So I'm going to grab a few and tote them over. They gotta be far away enough to where they're not claiming a bed. think I've already actually screwed that part up, but they're still breeding, so it's fine. Probably closer to my base. I might set up a couple little stations for them. I should have grabbed a minecart from all that iron. Let's scout out a spot real quick to set these dudes up. I'm thinking maybe on that island right there. We can make a little miniature trading hall for the time being. So yeah, I'm going to grab my railroad tracks. I'm going to grab some iron to make some minecarts. Do I still have railroad tracks, or is that one of the casualties of... Oh, nope, there we go. Let's make some sticks real quick, because I might need some more tracks. Now we have unlimited power, iron. So, tracks are easy to make. And redstone blocks for the powered ones. And, yeah. Scram. I'll get all this stuff and sleep, and then go grab a villager. Alright, I got everything. Got a little setup here to easily pull a villager out. Let's get the hitboxes so I don't hit him. And then what I'm going to do is take my boat. Why did he go back down there? And let's see if I can get him real quick. Get in there. Nice. Boat him over to the water. And take him where I want to go. Do I still have the slabs? Nice. So while I was transporting villagers up there, which was a giant task, it wasn't the easiest thing to do, but I've figured out a little bit of a method. Actually, I'm going to do this over here where it's flat and easier. I don't know. I don't think it'll screw up the village or the iron farm, but we'll see. Starts messing it up, then I'll just move it. But yeah, what I did, and it made it so much easier, was I built basically a little track like this. I built it out of glass the first time. Just because it's what I had on me. And I don't have silk touch, so I made it extremely harder. Is he rowing? Is he going somewhere? I just took these down for a reason, didn't I? Yeah, the glass I was able to fit, like, inside this little area that I'm about to make. Like the one by one, since you don't take damage from glass. I suppose I could do it with those slabs. Man, I'm so scatterbrained. I'm going to do it with the slabs. What? Why would you do that? Alright, so bring this out this way. Excuse me, sir? Excuse me? So, yeah, break him out of the boat. He will get back up there. I will put him back in the boat. Get in the boat. Nice. And we can go over here. We won't suffocate because those are transparent blocks. I can get out. Break the boat. Give me my boat back. Yeah, and then, let me see. Let's get some more rails. This was the easiest way I found to get him into a minecart. So, do that, and boom, he's in the minecart. And then over here, I can power it or break that and push him and put him where I want him to go. Which is a very good question. Where do I want him to go? Let's set them up here. This should work. He'll fit nicely in there. Now we just got to bring this over there, which is pretty simple. Torch was there. I think I had an extra one. Mushrooms, why? Oh, yeah. I need to make some. Let's just get a stack of sticks real quick. And then let's just make a whole bunch of rails. All right. Gonna be his home. Get my redstone blocks. Power that guy. Power that guy. Go ahead and push this guy. Bye. Break you. Power. Oh, let's break that again. Redstone block. Power drill. Sorry, I just got home from work. My brain's kind of fried. That's fine. That way, when we push him in there, he'll just bounce back and go that way. Keep going. What? Oh. Forgot about that one. Alright, we got him over here. Break that. Let me go grab a lectern and probably a trapdoor. I forget exactly how this mechanic works. I might make a clock too. I don't know. But I will be right back. Alright guys, I am back. Let's see. Man, look how much iron that has given me just from... What? That's like a stack just from playing around here. That is insane. But yes, I got my lantern. I have an item frame and a clock because you can only reset trades during working hours. And it's, well, basically, I think it's at 1,000 and between 1,000 and 9,000, maybe. The time during the day, it's like right. I forget the visual on it. Anyways, it's dark now, and I can't reset his trades, so this was probably a horrible time to come back. Oh my god, it's another cat. This doubles as a cat farm. Sorry. Yeah, so I will be right back again when it's time for that guy to work so I can reset his trades. Alright, I am back again. It's still not quite time to reset the trades, I don't think. I think this blue line has to be, like, touching that corner or touching that corner, something like that. I might look up how to basically set the set a redstone lamp to come on at certain times of the day. I know you can use a comparator to tell whether it's like, oh my god, there's another cat over there. This is a cat farm. This is amazing. I'm distracted. No idea. Oh, yeah. You can use a daylight sensor to tell exactly what time of the day it is using a comparator. And then you can have it come on only during working hours. So it's easier to tell when you can trade with him. But boom. It is working hours. Let's see what we got here. There's no book there. That's bad form. Oh, maybe it wasn't work hours quite yet. All right, reset, man. Dude. All right, working hours. Let's see what we can get here. Not off to a good start at all. Oh my gosh. Thanks, guy. Silk touch for 13. That I'm going to keep that cuz I need silk touch so I can break glass again. I had that on my shovel and I was using a shovel to break glass, but yeah. So, that's all I'm going to be doing here for a little while is setting up some villagers, some mini trading hall. I might steal a zombie out of there and bring him over here and let him turn these dudes into zombie villagers. And I don't have any weakness potions, don't have much gold, but I'm going to try and get these guys cured and get silk touch for one emerald because I have 27 of them from shipwrecks. Yes. I want to go ahead and lock him in, but I don't have enough emeralds. That's horrible. All right. That's going to do it for me for this episode. I hope it's a little bit shorter. I want to put out, you know, maybe one more a week if I have the time. It's really hard, you know, doing life and adulting and stuff. But there's links in the descriptions for the farms. And if you like what you saw, leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. The more there is, the more I will put out. Oh, all right. And on that note, Mr. Iron Golem here is going to do a dance for you. Or, okay, he stopped. I'll see you guys later. Bye.